draw things.
Well, hi kids. This is a tutorial for Draw Things, the stable Diffusion client for Mac and iOS. Draw Things is free on the app stores. There's a new website, drawthings.ai. Today I'm showing a workflow called Sketch to Image. If you're familiar with a controlnet for SD 1.5 called Scribble, Stability Sketch is the same idea but rendering in XL at higher resolution.
Draw Things.
This will be a fast tutorial. It works on both Mac and iPhone, and it's suitable for beginners.
Draw Things.
Now, our first fetch quest in this adventure is to go on HuggingFace and get the link to download the sketch control for SDXL. I'll put a link in the video description, but of course that link might change someday. You're looking for a page called Control Laura for SDXL. Now, once on the HuggingFace page, under the Files tab, we have two options. Rank 256 is the larger version. Rank 128 is about half the file size, and it's gonna run a little faster. It's similar to using an 8-bit quantized model, mostly the same quality, but packed in a more efficient format.
Draw Things.
Find the control called Sketch, and copy the download link. In Draw Things, open the control drop-down and choose Manage at the top of the list. Click on the tab that says Import Control, and in the first drop-down, pick the option that says Enter URL, and we're gonna paste the address from Hugging Face. I'm going to rename it Sketch SDXL. And under the ControlNet preprocessor, choose InPaint, and then we'll import. Now the Mac install is exactly the same, so I'm not going to show it. At the end, we'll have the option to delete the model from the downloads folder. Let's create a new project and rename it Sketch. And I'll reset my parameters to default so we're on the same page. First, we need to load an SDXL model. I'm using Dynavision because it's trained on modern cartoons like Pixar, and it always delivers something cute. But you can use any XL generation model. Now, under the LoRa, I'm adding Hyper 8 for accelerated rendering. Controls are sometimes wonky with an accelerated model, but Sketch seems to do just fine. With Hyper 8, I'm going to set my steps to 8. And text guidance to 1. Now, under the control menu, I'll search for Sketch, and I'm going to load it and leave it at the default settings. Even though we set Sketch to an InPaint preprocessor, we're not using image to image, so leave strength to 100% or text only.
Draw Things.
At this point, go ahead and import your drawing onto the canvas. On a Mac, we can drag and drop directly. On iOS, it's a long click on the paste button, or right click on Mac, to navigate to your photos and files. Now you'll probably need to adjust the render size to something that fits the drawing's ratio. XL renders best at 1 megapixel or close to 1024 on each side. Use the ratio icons under Normal for preset sizes with the nearest XL ratio.
Draw Things.
And next comes the technical part. We're going to set the mysterious and complicated noise settings for SDXL. And that's not hyperbole. Those settings are complicated and mysterious. I won't try to explain here, so just set the parameters exactly as I show. Under Original Noise, set the width to 512 and the height to 384. Notice the ratio says it's 4:3. Under Target Noise, set the width to 768 and the height to 576. And notice once again the 4:3 ratio. under negative original noise. Set the width to 1024 and the height to 768. Now, it won't matter what size the final render is, these noise settings will still work if you set them exactly as here. But when you do change the render size, the noise settings are going to be overwritten by DrawThings defaults. So you'll need to go back into the advanced menu and reset these three noise ratios to the settings as I showed them here.
DrawThings.
Now, one last tip when using DrawThings is how the imported drawing appears as its own thumbnail in the history. As we adjust the prompt and settings, we can keep returning to that imported thumbnail to render another sketch to image. The current prompt and all of our stable diffusion parameters will stay.
DrawThings.
Now on Mac, the history is the entire right sidebar. It can be hidden with a button, and there are three ways to view the thumbnails.
DrawThings.
The time icon shows every image in chronological order, the same order they were created. The coffee icon shows only the final renders. This mode hides any working images, including our imported thumbnail. If you don't see it, switch to another mode. The middle icon is a straight link, and that arranges the history so that we're only seeing the most recent renders and the images they build on. This mode will always show the imported thumbnail, making it easier to skip back to, while hiding the abandoned branches of our project. On iPhone, our history is a separate window accessed through the history button on the bottom right, but back in the generation window, we have this orange history slider. And assuming you render one image at a time, we can always slide back one step to return to the drawing on the canvas. The behavior is the same as on Mac. Returning to that imported canvas doesn't change the current prompt or parameters, so we can safely go back to the same drawing again and again until we get the image we want.
DrawThings.
Well, that's all we have time for, and as usual, I hope you had a learn. Give this video a like if you think it will help others.
DrawThings.
And subscribe if you want to know about my next one. Happy rendering, and I'll see you next time.